Hallelujah, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. This is CSAM Bible Study Precept Session. And normally, it is... normally, it is Evangelist Read Night. But she'll be doing... having her session tomorrow night at 6. So tonight, I'm going to be ministering doctrine on Psalms 23:1-3. Psalms 23, 1 through 3. And really, I'm going to touch up a lot on my shepherd. My shepherd. My shepherd. And this is your Apostle Reddick. Apostle Chief Elder of Converting Souls Apostolic Ministries Church Unincorporated. And so, Psalms 23, let us bow our head. Heavenly Father, we just thank you for this word tonight. We thank you that we can gather and bless your name. We thank you that you are righteous and true, that you lead us and guide us and nourish us by your word. We thank you that you are the chief shepherd, the good shepherd, the great shepherd of our souls. And we ask you tonight to be glorified, for you are the author of eternal salvation, and you reign as King, as God, whose scepter is a scepter of righteousness. And so, Father, as we look to you, we ask you to have your way. In Jesus Christ's name, amen. Psalms 23, verses 1 through 3. Psalms 23, verses 1 through 3. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. He leadeth me beside the still waters. He restores my soul. He leadeth me in the paths of righteousness for his name's sake. He leadeth me in the paths of righteousness for his name's sake. The Lord is my shepherd. He is my shepherd. I shall not want. The Lord, Adonai, Elion, Jesus, our eternal Savior. He is our shepherd, and we shall have no need. No need. Jesus Christ is our spiritual shepherd. Anything of the spiritual nature that we need, he provides. He is our shepherd. We shall have no want. But he doesn't just stop there. He will provide our natural need as well. And we must understand the shepherd. The Lord being our shepherd. He says, you will have no need. That's what I shall not want. I shall not want. He is the good shepherd, the great shepherd, and the chief shepherd. And go to John, the 10th chapter. John, the 10th chapter. John 10:14 says, Jesus is speaking. The words are in red. He says, I am the good shepherd, and know my sheep, and am known of mine. He is the good shepherd. He knows his sheep. He takes knowledge of them. Isn't that's the Lord. He takes knowledge of us. That's, you want a God that takes knowledge of you. You want a God that knows about you. You want a God that listens to you. You want a God that's there for you, that's truthful. He says, I am the good shepherd. The good shepherd. He is the good shepherd. In other words, he is the elder shepherd. Because a shepherd has the eldership over God's flock. Understand that the shepherd has the eldership over God's flock. And he says, I am the good elder. In other words, the Bible says he is the bishop and shepherd of our souls. I want you to go to 1 Peter. He is the bishop and shepherd of our souls. First Peter 5:1, it says, the elders which are among you I exhort, who am also an elder. Now he's addressing elders. Now this could mean bishops. That's the highest pastor. If you've never been taught that, understand that's the highest pastor. Well, it's not the highest pastor, but that's, if you look at, how do I want to explain it? Bishops are not the highest pastors. There are apostles, elders. But bishops are like over the pastors. Bishop is like the chief shepherd. He's the leader. If you look at bishops, they are right here. It says verse 2, it says, and witness of the sufferings of Christ, and also a partaker of the glory that shall be revealed. Feed the flock of God which is among you. That's taking care of your need. When the elder feeds you, when the pastor, the shepherd feeds you, he's taking care of your need and he's ruling. He's taking care of your need. He's leading you in the paths. Let's look at that again. You know, it says, he maketh me to lie down in green pastures. He leadeth me beside the still waters. He restores my soul. This is a shepherd. This is a shepherd. He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. He leadeth me beside the still waters. He restores my soul. You know, the Bible says in Psalms 19:7, the law of the Lord is perfect, converting the soul. The testimony of the Lord is sure, making wise the simple. The law of the Lord is perfect, converting the soul. He's restoring the soul by his words, by his precepts, by his teaching, by his doctrine. And so here it is. It says, feed the flock of God, those that are elders, which is among you, taking the oversight. That means shepherding them. And there's more to shepherding them. But here we see, taking the oversight, therefore, thereof, not by constraint, but willingly, not for filthy lucre, but of a ready mind, neither as being lords over God's heritage. As a shepherd, you are over God's heritage. If you are a pastor and you have a congregation, or you can have two people and be a shepherd. I want you to understand that. You are over God's heritage, even if it's two, even one. You are over God's heritage. I don't care who got thousands of people and who got one. You are over God's heritage. And just like he would say to the thousand, he say to the one that got the one, feed the flock, take the oversight, be their shepherd, be their guide, be their leader. And do it being an example to them. Be an example. If you want a pastor, how do you live your life? Are you that example? Do you represent the spiritual chief shepherd? Which is the next verse. And when the chief shepherd shall appear, you shall receive a crown of glory that fadeth not away. It fades not away. It fades not away. It fades not away. I want you to understand that Jesus is our chief shepherd. He's the chief elder. And just like the Apostle Peter, he says, I'm an elder. The apostle elders are the chief elders. They are the apostles and high priests of our profession. But here we're talking about the bishop and shepherd. As an apostle, he's saying, listen, I'm an elder, and I'm going to exhort the other elders. And he could be exhorting other apostles or bishops. Because then he's the chief shepherd. The chief shepherd. Let's go to Hebrews 13:20. It says, now the God of peace that brought again from the dead our Lord Jesus, the great shepherd of the sheep, through the blood of the everlasting covenant, make you perfect in every good work to do his will, working in you that which is well-pleasing in his sight through Jesus Christ, to whom be glory forever and ever. Amen. The God of peace that brought again the dead from the dead, our Lord Jesus, that great shepherd of the sheep. Jesus, the Lord is my shepherd. Can you say that? The Lord is my shepherd. He's the spiritual shepherd, the bishop. The bishop. The Bible says he's the great shepherd that brings the everlasting covenant, the everlasting testament, the New Testament. Do you know we are still fulfilling in the New Testament? God is still having times where he has seasons in which he rises. His name is Yah. He rides the clouds by his name. But when we begin to speak of Yah, Y-A-H, J-A-H, we understand that it is time for an appointed hour, a time where God wants to fulfill his will in your life. The everlasting covenant, the everlasting testament by the sprinkling of Christ's blood. The one he rose from the dead. Now, our likeness to Christ is a designation. Not everybody is a pastor, but a pastor is like Christ, and his designation is to be that shepherd over the heritage of God, the flock of God. And as Ephesians 4:1, pastors, and then we have the bishops and or the elders. And usually if a elder, to be called an elder, that's dignity. Bishops are called bishops, but they are called elders. The elder is the dignity of their office. There's something about the office of a full-age one, a mature one. There's some dignity there. Every pastor should have some dignity. Remember to take the oversight, to guide, to guard, to fold the flock, to lead, to nourishment. Remember Psalms 23:3? How we do that is we feed the flock. That is the first thing that came out of his mouth after greeting them. He said, feed the flock of God. Take the oversight. I need you to shepherd them because the Lord is our shepherd. And we must guide the sheep in the spiritual nature that Christ guides us, the chief shepherd. We pastors help perfect the saints. They bring in the edification, the exhortation, and the comforting. But they feed you that spiritual nourishment that you need. They feed you the word of God. And I pray that it is sound doctrine, because sound doctrine is healthy doctrine, healthy teaching of the word of God. It's healthy. And I want you to understand, the Bible says that in taking the oversight, we have to lead you to nourishment. A shepherd leads to nourishing. God restores the soul through the doctrine that a pastor teaches. He restores the soul, he converts it. And one addition to being restored is being baptized in the Spirit. And I want you to understand that Christ is leading us and guiding us as the spiritual shepherd. The spiritual shepherd. And so he's the bishop and shepherd of our souls. And so tonight, we've understanding the place of a shepherd in the spiritual sense, but understand that in Christ's kingdom, he is always looking to convert us. And it starts with his word, which nourishes our soul and makes us healthy within. And so I want you to understand tonight, just as the psalmist said, the Lord is my shepherd. God is your shepherd. Jesus Christ is your shepherd. He's the good shepherd, the chief shepherd, the great shepherd. And I want you to know that as a shepherd, we must feed the flock of God with a ready mind. being an example. And I want you to understand that we are the spiritual feeders, the rulers, the governors. Of the flock of God. That's the bishop. But as an elder, you must understand, this is where Jesus was also the apostle elder. The good shepherd, the great shepherd, and the chief shepherd. The bishop, he carried the title also, the bishop and shepherd of our souls. Shepherd is also a priest. He played both roles in the earth. The high priest, he was the final sacrifice, the one that was rose from the dead, and the sprinkling of our souls by his blood. You know, Jesus Christ's blood still speaks today. And he's speaking for you, and he's speaking for me. And he wants you to know, if you're a non-believer, he's speaking, and he wants to sprinkle you, and he wants your soul healthy. He wants your soul sound. He wants your soul to prosper. And so understand Psalm 23. The Lord is our shepherd. Heavenly Father, we just thank you for this word tonight. We thank you that you desire to teach us your ways, give us your precepts, and show us your doctrine. As the shepherd of our souls, you lead us, you feed us, you nourish us. And Father, we thank you, and we give you the glory and the honor for our chief shepherd, our spiritual shepherd, our spiritual pastor, the bishop, the Lord Jesus Christ. For that is his divine title. He is the bishop and shepherd of our soul. And we bless him tonight, and we give him the glory and the honor that's due unto his name. And we magnify him and thank him for being the bishop and shepherd of our souls. Thank you for nourishing us. Thank you for feeding us and ruling us as our spiritual governor. In Jesus Christ's name I pray. The eternal Savior. Amen and amen.
Amen.
The Apostles' Benediction. Peace and blessings in and through the Holy Ghost. God's Spirit, Ruach Hakodesh, leading us in eternal life with moral discernment and in Christ's full stature. In Christ's authority, this is your apostle, Reddick, apostle chief elder.